Okay. So this is about sizes and then about form. So there are some problems which are fortunately without solutions in the book. So you should develop them yourself. So for example, let me just copy the nice picture. So there is a cell paper. 1, 2, 3, 4. And there is a picture like this. But now I need to draw something. So you can see this picture in this page. And the question is, can you divide it in two equal parts? Equal parts. Just show it. Just draw it on the paper.
Как ее разрезать на две одинаковые части?
Вот есть такая фигурка.
Надо понять, можно ли...
Ее даже не обязательно делить по клеточкам. А на три? И на четыре? Ну, на три давайте. На четыре я даже... На четыре даже проще, но давайте на три. О, какие у вас красивые части. Но это... Да, на две, это я понял. Да. Ничего. Разделили на 2-3-4 части. Ну, давайте вы нарисуете картиночку и разделите. Это there is a unknown. Что? Just на две сначала. Two equal parts. We should divide this. For two equal parts there are even two different solutions. So we should divide this figure into two equal parts. And
Женя, условия вы поняли? Да. Да, изрезал, а две конкретные части.
Я. Теперь на три и на четыре.
На три.
На две, да. На две. Это есть одно из двух решений, да. Ну, теперь на три и на четыре надо разделить. One should divide it into two, three and four parts. So there were some solutions for two already, but I haven't seen solutions for three and four yet.
Нет, не получается, потому что у этой штуки есть такой вот угол, который вы не можете.
Чего я не знаю, what I don't know how to divide the five pieces. Maybe it's possible.
А на три так? Как бы на три не по клеточкам.
Не по клеточкам. So you don't need to follow the lines. So you can cut the figure not according to the, it's just for your for drawing, but it's not necessary. Oh,
нечтение части вы придумали самое простое, да. Теперь на три. Причем не обязательно по клеточкам. Это не важно, в этом случае нам надо, чтобы.
А если не по клеточкам, то на три так же, как на пять.
А как на пять? Они будут не связаны.
Параллельный перенос.
Они будут не связаны.
Если параллельный перенос, то на пятую часть.
Но части будут не связаны.
Ну,
нет.
Дайте 20.
Can you draw another solution?
Yes.
I can try to draw again the picture, but to mix it on this.
Возьмите какую-нибудь получше планету, ничего не
надо. Это как раз линии здесь будут мелочи. And the figure is like this. So there is a very easy solution. We just cut this into four nice pieces without all your difficult things. So there are four equal parts. Okay, but what are let's draw other. So there is like this, and just the same thing with the same kind of additional thing. So this is.
And I use a solution for four parts.
And where is the solution for four? How it's related to this?
It is.
Okay, but there's different solution. You can make a solution for four parts, like this, yeah? Yeah, you can cut into two parts, and then each of these parts can be cut here. Okay, so for two we have solution, for four we have now even three solutions, but for three parts. Does anybody have a solution for three parts?
Есть еще очень красивое решение на две части.
У меня есть. У меня есть.
For three parts, for four parts, or for two parts?
For three parts.
For three parts. Okay. So, two or four. Okay. If you have a solution for three parts, let me try.
Да.
И чтобы фигурка тут
начинала? Нет, отрез,
представляете? Wait a bit. If you want to show something, just show us. You don't need to check it first. And then draw one.
Нельзя.
So let me just draw the picture. Okay, so who has a solution for three parts? Коля, you and check your solution.
У него оно есть, но он его не понимает.
There is a special, maybe you heard of this. There is a special system called ArchivOrg. That everybody can write a mathematical paper and put it into some special place, which is called ArchivOrg. And then it's available for all other people. So unlike Fermat, who need to write letters to some special person. Now mathematicians can write a paper and put it there, and everybody can see it. But then there is special word. If you write a paper and then you find the paper is incorrect, you can do something which is called retract. Then your paper is deleted. Still, it's visible that you had a paper. You decided to take it back, but at least people know that you don't like. So don't claim. So you have a solution for three, but now it's abstract. Any other solution for three? Не обязательно повторять. We don't need to follow the lines. I can even give a kind of hint. Just this solution for two. Is can be used as inspiration. Это можно рассматривать как указание для тревоги.
мы разрезали два, а вот у нас есть такое, оно не очень симметричное, но решение. Может быть, кто-нибудь, глядя на это, догадается, как сделать это?
Looking at this picture, you can try to guess how to do it for three. You have an idea.
Но все-таки на две части. Ну, такое симпатичное решение.
Окей. Окей. As a special prize that you keep silent last time, you are now allowed to show some for two. Окей. Нет. Вы хотите для каких? На сколько? For two parts. Окей. Okay. Which is different from this one.
Ну правда, красиво. Ну правда, что красиво.
У меня еще одно есть решение.
Для скольких?
Для двух.
Да, для
двух.
Let's draw it now. So you want to retract?
I retract.
Okay. For two or three or four? For two. Okay, so let me prepare the field. Divide the field into three equal pieces.
So this is equal to this, and this is equal to this. And also this is equal to this, and this and this.
Ну почему они все будут одинаковы?
Со сдвигом называется скользящая симметрия.
In English it's a very strange thing. It's called skew. I think skew symmetry. I'm not very sure about this. Symmetry.
И еще вот то, что на правой картинке, господа, это очень важная штука, называется параллельный перенос.
So what there is a in our English world. So we have a how do we move this piece to this piece? We just shift everything to unit side. So it's called shift in English. Or translation. But in Russian we don't have one word for this. And it's called parallelism. Oh, we have actually. We can say it's dvig. But it's not very mathematical, but it's understandable. If you want to say more formal, it's called parallel.
На самом деле не так много слов надо запоминать. Поворот, параллельный перенос и это самое ваше skew symmetry. Всего-то бывает три способа двигать плоскость, так что не думайте, что это придется запоминать слишком много.
Ну, слов разные, слова разные. Окей.